Another matrix we've worked with is this matrix, which is I, the identity matrix, minus the hat matrix. And we're going to see what the trace is and quickly get some properties on this matrix. If we write out a couple of entries, we have H11, H12, H21, H22, and this carries on down to HN of N. So whatever these entries are, we already agreed that the hat matrix was symmetric. So if we're talking about the operation subtracting the hat matrix from the identity matrix, what that's basically saying is that on the diagonals, we're taking 1 minus, 1 minus, 1 minus, all the way down the diagonals. And then on the off diagonals, we're taking the operation 0 minus. Well, that looks like a symmetrical operation to me. One procedure being carried out on the diagonal, the same procedure. If H12 and H21 were the same because it was symmetric, then 0 minus H21 and 0 minus H12 are also going to be symmetric. That makes the next point very easy to work with. What we're saying is that I minus H squared, let's have a look at what this is. Well, as this thing's symmetric, I want to find the identity minus H multiplied by the identity minus H transpose. Well, it's symmetric, so I can get rid of that transpose and I can just multiply this thing out. So I have an identity matrix squared, and I have to subtract the HI, and I have to subtract an IH, and I have to add a H squared. Well, the identity matrix squared is just an identity matrix. These two things here are the same, so I'm subtracting twice the identity matrix multiplied by the hat matrix. And the last thing, we already saw that the hat matrix was idempotent, so hat squared is hat. And then of course I can reduce this because we know that the identity matrix multiplied by a hat matrix is a hat matrix. So I have I minus 2H plus H. So in other words, I get back to identity minus the hat matrix. So I have another symmetric and idempotent matrix. And the one other thing that in one small place that I can think of comes in useful is just to know the trace of this. And we can just use the result that the trace of A plus B is equal to trace A plus trace B. So what I need to do to find the trace of I minus H is to find trace of I and subtract the trace of H. Well, we've seen already that the trace of the hat matrix is P. So what we need to do is find the trace of this identity matrix. And this identity matrix, the hat matrix, is n of order n by n. So this identity matrix must also be of order n by n, so it must have trace n. So the trace of this matrix must be n minus p. So, three properties of this other matrix. We subtract a hat matrix from the identity matrix. It's symmetric. I minus h transpose equals I minus h. It's idempotent. I minus h squared is equal to the identity minus h. And the trace of this matrix is equal to n minus p.